Hello and welcome to Africa Independent Television, AIT. The program is Democracy Today. I am Ijeoma Osamu. There are 4 months, which is about 16 weeks or 113 days until February 16, 2019, a day scheduled for the presidential election in Nigeria. And in 7 days' time, precisely November 2, substitution of candidates by political parties will officially close for the 2019 general elections. But there seems to be some level of fears coming from the opposition party, especially the People's Democratic Party, that the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, will conduct credible polls come 2019. The chairman and some members of the National Working Committee of the PDP raised some doubt on the credibility of the electoral umpire when they received delegation of the European Union of the Election Exploration in Nigeria in Abuja on Wednesday.
Most of the party were afraid that there won't be, that APC will not allow free and fair credible election in 2019. And so therefore, we decided to approach you to please prevail on the federal government of Nigeria to conduct free, fair, credible election. They wouldn't have been in power if they are not beneficiary of free, fair, credible election. We conducted it when we were in power, and that saw to their emergence. And today they are not interested in doing the same thing that we did for them in 2015.
The United States supports free, fair, transparent, and credible elections, and peace in the elections, a peaceful process, both before the elections and after, a peaceful transition to a new government, and that the United States does not have a candidate in these elections. You might say our candidate is the process. So let me assure you that I will bring this petition in the first instance to the attention of Ambassador Symington, and I can assure you that this will be read with interest all the way up.
In the same vein, in a special report a few months ago, the United States Institute of Peace mentioned that a lot of things will happen. Public conference in Nigeria, Independent National Electoral Commission will be mixed, as a lot of persons are having doubts. And in that report, they went further to say, although INEC was applauded for organizing broadly credible elections in 2015, some Nigerians are expressing concern that the commission's progress may not be sustained in 2019. The report also said more assertive communications by INEC, transparent resort management, staffing reforms, earlier and more consistent police operation preparations, improved internal democracy within political parties, and the creation of a specialized election offenses commission would likely alleviate some risk of violence in the 2019 election cycle. End of quotes. That's what the U.S. said. And this is our focus tonight as we are x-raying the possible fears of opposition parties in the forthcoming 2019 elections. We have guests in the studio to discuss the issue, and I'm being joined by two guests from two opposition parties. I have with me in the studio Olariwaju Osho. He is from the Abundant Nigeria Renewal Party. He is even preparing for that election, to be a part of the election. You're welcome to Democracy Today.
Thanks, Ijeoma.
And I also have with me here the former aide to Kaduna State Governors, three Kaduna State Governors, and is a member of the People's Democratic Party. They've been raising alarm. He is Emmanuel Dennis. You're welcome to Democracy Today.
My pleasure to be here, and always.
I also like to let you know that we also extended invitation to the Independent National Electoral Commission, but it seems today has been a very busy day since morning. They've been in very tight meeting, and just this evening they said they couldn't make it because they had visitors around them. And but before we go, let's just start by asking the PDP, what are your fears that your party has been raising so much fears for?
Well, it's better we just take it from the very start. You know, when we talk about preparations for a general election, of course, you know, the process is going to commence from updating the voters register. It's going to commence with continuous voter registration. From that very time that we started having continuous voter registration, complaints have been everywhere. We have seen through the social media, news channels like yours and other channels, people have repeatedly complained
about
INEC registering underage children. This is where it all started.
But we don't have proof.
No, honestly, these are things that we have seen everywhere. It started from there. We saw things like that happening in places up north, even specifically in Kano. This very INEC came out and told us that this is not existing, and then every other person decided to keep quiet about it and allow it to flow.
Mr. Manuel, I would like to make something clear here.
Yes, I'm with you.
Sorry, I have to let you know this.
Okay.
If you want to give us answer, you need to give us proof.
Of course, definitely.
You need to back your facts.
Definitely.
You
would get
back your
when we get to that, of
facts.
Course, definitely when we get to that bridge, we are able to show you, but pictures are there to show that underage children were registering in Kano. But we've gone past that. If you see the elections that this current INEC have conducted ever since they came into office, you and I know very well that most of the things they did have always been inconclusive. From a Edo election down through the one we have in Osun State very recently. Now let me tell you something. If you see the party expressing or entertaining fear about what INEC is about to do or how the elections of 2019 may likely pan out, it is not the reasons for this is not far-fetched. It is very, very clear to everyone who is carefully observing and watching that because this very INEC has always been inconclusive in the attitude and the way they do things, it is a clear indication that hopefully or possibly it is possible that 2019 may also end up inconclusive. Now look at Osun State. Let me just tell you. Take a very good look at Osun State. It was a clear election that was conducted. Somebody was leading. And then somewhere along the line, people came up and said, the election is inconclusive. You have to do A, B, C, D, X, Y, Z and conduct elections. And then people decided to connive with people, to disenfranchise people, and do not allow people to go there and vote, and then you still expect that people should have confidence to believe that this INEC will conduct an election that is free, fair, and credible.
Mr. Dennis, some persons will say that your comments are unfounded because you are
anyone who thinks the comments are unfounded means the person is not living in Nigeria. But if you are living in Nigeria right here and you are a living witness to what transpired in Osun State, I am only using Osun as an example. Of course, I don't even want to go back to Edo, neither do I want to go to Ekiti, or do I want to go to Ondo State. I am only using the very current example where we have something that every single person who is living in Nigeria can attest to, that there was an election conducted. In the process of releasing the results, INEC decided to change the goalposts. They stopped halfway and said the election was inconclusive.
Okay,
they decided to set another day for the election to be conducted.
We need to also ask others who are stakeholders in election matters in Nigeria here. You are from the Abundant Nigerian Renewal Party, one of those parties that we registered the last time.
No, we were 2 years old. 2017.
What do you think? Do you think INEC is not capable of conducting a credible election in 2019?
Yeah, I don't think INEC will be capable because of the scenario of the big parties.
You're blaming the politicians?
The big parties, yes. All the cases that my colleague threw up. You know, the big parties are destroying democracy in Nigeria. They are destroying the process and are making it difficult for the umpire to be able to do a good work. For example, in some of the state that you mentioned, I was in Osun, and you know, PDP spent billions APC spend billions. What were they fighting for? So because they were fighting, both of them are fighting, you know, to get the soul of the state, they are willing to use anything to destroy the system. And INEC is not from heaven. INEC is our INEC. And it is the society that produced INEC. And the society is destroying INEC.
Now, before we came on this program, you made a statement. You said your fears is that INEC may be and may not be able to give us credibility come 2019.
Yes.
So why did you make that statement?
For me, I believe the fault of INEC, for example, is in taking total charge of the conduct of the election. If you go to a typical polling unit, for example, in Osun or in Ekiti, you find some people are hibernating around the polling stations. They will park a car, load the boot of the car with millions of naira, and they beckon people as they are coming to vote.
Vote buying.
Yes, vote buying. And INEC is not able to take charge of that. We have police, we have army. I believe that, I mean, for example, INEC should be able to cordon off 500 meters away to the left, to the right, to the front, to the back of a polling station, and make sure that the election is free. For example, people come to vote, they are not free. They are under BS. None of them are, you know, they are threatened that if you don't vote for this party, you know your family, you know this and that.
You don't say.
Yes. Nigerians are going through a lot of stress to select candidates. So elections are not free, elections are not fair, so they can't be credible. And it is the two big parties that are responsible. And then INEC refused to use his power, and with his stick, you know, cut down off the whole area and make sure that the security agencies do their work.
Why but are you don't you think if INEC with the stick, people will still complain? And remember that there was a policy that they introduced in the Osun election about you don't take your smartphones to polling units, and you have to stay away, people have to stay away for a little bit, some meters away from the cubicle where you vote.
Yeah, on paper.
So those are policies that they can introduce.
Yes, because the big parties were desperate. Let me tell you what happened in Osun. In Osun, because the big parties were desperate, PDP did this and APC did it.
ANP didn't do it.
We get the money. We are a party trying to transform Nigeria. We can't transform Nigeria the kind of behaviors that the big parties are waiting in Nigeria. You know what happened, Osho? They put a gun. I mean, at times they put gun on the ground. At times they put cutlass on the ground, machete, and they will say, collect this money and cross it to swear.
How did you know that they were PDP and APC members?
They were the big parties fighting for the
solution. Did they wear PDP cap?
You know the result now.
Yeah, you didn't see them.
We saw them. The big parties know what they are doing to destroy democracy in Nigeria.
All right.
Because they don't want Nigeria to progress. They are there for selfish interests, and whatever they do affect either. And because you know, it's like the case of the cat to calling the pot black. The fear of PDP today, they knew the tricks. You know, we have another that it is the thieves that know the strategy or the track of the thieves on the mountain. They themselves did all this before. That's why they are afraid and crying woof woof woof.
So you think your party will come and do wonders?
But we are here to the new Nigeria. We are
When you are trying to build a new political party, you have a lot of things to say, you know, just to try to win membership. But the fact will always be there for everyone to see. I still maintain the fact that INEC, the way it is presently constituted, and considering the elections they have conducted so far, I'm being empirical about things. I am citing examples of elections that this INEC has conducted so far. We started with inconclusiveness. Everything this INEC did when they got into office was inconclusive. And you know, when PDP was in government, when PDP was in power, we normally have elections that will be conducted and concluded, and results will be declared, and winners will emerge. You could hardly see or hardly hear where people will begin to tell you this election is inconclusive, and therefore we have to shift dates.
Mr. Dennis,
and the issue of vote buying that we are talking about today.
Let me call you. Mr. Dennis, but I need to ask you a question.
All right.
If election is declared inconclusive, does that make that election a bad election?
Of course, you will begin to find out the reasons why it was declared.
But does that not mean that our elections are becoming credible?
No, you have to find out why the election was declared inconclusive. If it is that an opposition party or an opposition candidate was leading, and then someone somewhere decides to begin to look for some technicalities to declare a free fair election inconclusive because you want to skew the process to favor you, that becomes a problem. But if you are conducting an election and then you notice that there are irregularities, definite irregularities for everybody to see, and then you say, okay, I hold it here and then let's do this thing some other time. It is clear. For instance, where you have card reader that is not reading well, and then you say, okay, because the card reader could not accredit the voters that came on board, we have to suspend this. Everybody understands that. But when you get up and begin to tell Nigerians that votes that you cancelled is more than, when you are using double standards to judge, it becomes a problem. We have seen where you declared people winners when you, everybody knows very well that the votes that they call voided votes outnumber the ones in which the winner, eventual winner, used to, you know, scale through. But at the end of the day, you decided to skew the process and do it differently in another place. This is where the problem is. This is where we are having problem with INEC. This is why we are saying that INEC perhaps is planning or putting up things together to skew the process in 20.
All right, if you're still there, you're watching Democracy Today, reaching you live from Paduma Hill Station here in Africa Independent Television. Remember, you can join us via our Twitter handle and our Facebook page. You just go to Democracy Today, you like our page, you drop a comment. Or you can also follow us on our Twitter handle at Democracy Number 2 Day with a double Y. Or you follow me on my Twitter handle at EJ Osama. We'll be right back after the short break. Stay with us.
This is Ikolo Community, and this is Otana Community. As election time nears, politicians arrive with money. Members of Ikolo Community sell their vote, but Otana Community refuses to be settled. They vote for the candidates of their choice.
I do solemnly swear that everything...
After election, Ikolo school needs repairs. But the politician has already settled them. Otana hospital needs repairs too. Otana community demands action and gets results. Your vote is powerful. It builds the future. Don't be settled. No sit down look. No sit down look.
Make una no sit down look.
Well, we just saw that, like you said before, you saw what INEC is trying to sensitize Nigerians.
The problem is there. That's what they are doing, the sensitization. The problem is a huge problem in our country. You know, I was campaigning, during the primaries, I was campaigning to some guys in National Assembly. And he was telling me that in the last election, even that the PDP was the president of Nigeria then, that produced the president then, he said APC offered him 4,000 naira. He refused. And as he was going, PDP called him and beckoned him and offered him 6,000 naira. I'm telling you a life story.
He's arrested.
Sure. He refused. So
if you have a video evidence of this statement you are making,
then we interview Nigerians. This guy can.
Because we are very careful when it comes to this program, so we don't just come out and say things we are not too sure.
I know, but this is what happens in Nigeria.
If you are taking to the courtroom now,
I produce the guy who need proof.
Yeah, I can produce the guy will come to say it.
Because
can you show us pictures and video evidence? So that's it. So we just add, if you want to make comments on this program, just back your comments with comments.
Let me tell you this, IG. In the Osun election, I was with election monitors from South Africa. They showed video of policeman, Nigerian police, offering money. He was the one that carried the money and was offering it. The IG denied it until they showed the picture.
Then
we may say because we don't want this and we don't want that. We don't want to. See, if we continue to beg the question, democracy cannot develop in Nigeria. We need to appeal to PDP. We need to appeal to APC. They should pursue national interest and not selfish interest. And because of their love for national interest, they should allow people to vote freely. They should take away all their monies to build hospitals, give votes, not offer it to people to buy their votes and then destroy the system.
Mr. Osho, you heard that yesterday the National Assembly, the Senate, passed the new Electoral Act Amendment Bill.
Yes.
And in that Electoral Act, issues of voting has been answered because the Act says that INEC has been given the power to use electronics. So they can translate results, yes, using the card reader.
Yes.
They can also do other things with the card reader.
Yes.
And that same electoral act, there is nothing like incident form again.
Yeah.
If the card reader cannot identify you, then that means you can't vote.
So I'm making some
you
progress.
See that as a progress elections.
It's progress in our election because the truth is that, for example, IG, the elections of Nigeria, they are too expensive. Why can't someone vote via email and put your BVN number, put your national ID card number? And you know, there was a system introduced by Road Safety. You know, if you try to register twice, the system raises a red flag and you are noted. So I'm not sure have a system like that that raises a red flag if you vote twice, you know, either through the polling booth or through email. We should try and bring innovation to our electoral process such that this huge money we waste on election conducting should be used to build hospitals, build roads, build
infrastructure. That is where you should credit PDP. That is where you should credit PDP, because the PDP was the one that introduced the card reader. And you see what you have just said now, it's just a bill that has been passed by the
other.
It's a bill that has just been passed. That bill must still go for presidential assent. You and I are aware that this bill was first sent to the presidency for assent, and the president declined it and raised some observations. The National Assembly have done its work perfectly well. I heard yesterday that all the observations that was raised by the president have been taken care of. Now the ball has been played back to Mr. President for his assent. We cannot begin to dance and say it's who until the president has appended his signature to that bill to make it law.
But do you see that bill as a way to solve some of the questions?
Well, you see, the fact remains that if we are going electronic, then we know we are going electronic. My party has been able to give to Nigerians PVCs, and then you have the card reader. The card reader is an electronic device which was intended and which is intended to promote and give more, add more credibility to our electoral process. I was expecting that under this government, they will also come and build on it and take it further and probably introduce us to an electronic system of voting, which wouldn't actually cost us anything to do. But you see, because some people are still there who have believe that they have not done enough to earn the credibility and the trust of Nigerians when they go back to meet the electorates. So they will want to do everything to skew the process to ensure that they will continue to rig elections and perpetuate themselves in office. But I am telling you that it may not work this time around. Why it will work is because Nigerians are becoming day by day more aware. Nigerians will not even be looking at just parties alone. Nigerians will look at those that you are presenting. If you are amongst those who have conscripted Nigeria to where we've seen ourselves today, you should not expect that we should return you back to office. Those ruling us today should do the needful. Take a step further. Give us electronic voting. And before we begin to dance and begin to rejoice, based on what the National Assembly has done fantastically this week, let us also pray that the president will be kind enough to append the signature so that this thing will become law.
All right, Mr. Osho, before you go, what's the way forward? Because we can't stop blaming the electoral umpire when we know that we'll be part of that same election. Yeah. We do not have another INEC.
Yeah.
This is the same INEC that we'll meet.
I think the way forward is actually in the society. Nigerian society is so messed up that money rules and reigns in every affair of our lives.
You are particularly worried about voter rights.
Sincerely, because if the society changes, for example, and they don't collect money to vote someone, then INEC, we have no choice than to just agree that, okay, A party had 2,000, B party had 1,500, A party is the winner. But money destroys system. Money destroys process. And Nigerian politics is
not just all money.
No, that money is bad money. Because when you offer money to buy vote, is bad money. When you offer money to truncate a process,
it's corruption.
Is bad money. It's corruption. So, you see, our psyche is so messed up as a people that you need to pity those of us who are aspiring for political office. When we go out there, the psyche is so destroyed, everyone is looking for money. And then when these guys that are big parties know that everybody is looking for money, they break the banks,
bring out the cash, the success, process is truncated, everything is destroyed.
All right,
you know, and that system can never produce good leaders that move Nigeria forward. That's why in 20 years of APC and PDP, Nigeria has been going around in circles, and other countries are moving forward, like Rwanda, for example. It's a shame for us. As
all right, that's the much we can take on the program tonight. Remember that you can also drop a comment with us on our Facebook page, Democracy Today. You just like our page, or you go to our Twitter handle and follow us at Democracy Number 2 Day. And also follow me on my Twitter handle at EG Osamo. I'll see you tomorrow by 7:30 p.m. Good night.